I'm Neelam ma'am here. Today I am going to teach you here chapter number 7, decimal numbers. Decimal numbers. And my topic is today comparison of decimal numbers and converting fraction into decimals. Converting fractions into decimals. First of all, whenever you are given two decimal numbers and you are asked to put appropriate sign greater than, less than, or is equal to, okay, then how to do those types of sums today here. I am taking practice on 3 today, some of the parts here. If the question is 0.07, okay. First of all, we will compare the whole number. Before decimals, we will compare whole number, okay. We will compare whole number. Here, whole number is 0 and 1. Greater is 1. First of all, compare the whole numbers before decimal. Decimal se pehle wale jo kya hai, ye whole number hai. These are whole number, and after decimal point there are digits in than 100. Okay. So now 0 is less than 1. Naturally, this 0.07 will be less than 1.107. Similarly, in second part, it is given to you here. This is A part, B part. Compare both of the whole numbers before decimal. See, this is decimal, okay? Before decimal, compare the whole numbers. Here, 7 is equal to 7, okay? 7 is equal to 7. We can't say ki both are equal. No. Now, after decimal, compare the digit at the 10th place. After decimal, now compare the digits at the 10th place of both of the decimal numbers. Here it is 3 and here it is 2. The digit in the first decimal number after decimal at 10th place is 3. Then 3. Then the digit in the second decimal number after decimal at 10th place is 2. 2 is 2. Now which one is greater? 3 is greater, na? 3 is greater than 2. 3 is greater than 2. Okay? Then first of all, you will compare whole numbers. Here I have compared whole numbers. 0 was less than 1. After that, here I have written here 0.07 is less than 1.107. Then I compared both of these decimal numbers. First of all, compare whole numbers. If whole numbers are equal, then compare the digit after decimal at 10th place. That is 3 and 2. 3 is greater than 2. Then we can say 7.35 is greater than 7.25. Okay. If it was smaller, then you will compare the digit at 1000th place. The digit at the 1000th place. Let's take other example here of this exercise here. 13.081. Now, first of all, you will make this like it. Okay. First of all, we can compare here. Directly, we can compare whole numbers. 1330. Okay. Compare whole numbers. compare whole numbers. Before decimal are whole numbers. It is 13 equal to 13. 13 is there in both of the decimal number. Now, compare the digits after decimal at 10th place. Now, compare the digit at 10th place. 10th place. Okay? 10th place we get 1 in the first decimal number and in the second decimal number it is 0. So 1 is greater than 0. 1 is greater than 0. So we can say ki 13.18 is greater than 13.081. In this way you will complete the end. The only part you will complete here. Then converting fractions to decimal number. Okay. Converting fractions to decimal number. Okay. We know ki the number of digits after the decimal point depends on the number of zeros in the denominator. Earlier you have learned how to write 7 upon 10. What is 7 upon 10? Means the number of digits after the decimal depend upon the number of zeros in the denominator. Here it can be written here 0.7. Okay, only one zero is there. Number of zero in denominator 1. So after decimal, the digit which is at in the denominator will be at the first place here. Will be one only. After decimal, the digit after the decimal, the digit will be only here 1. If it is divided by 10, because in 10 there is only 1 0. The number of digits after the decimal point depends on the number of zeros in the denominator. 137 upon 100. There are 2 zeros in denominator. So, 2 digits will be, it will become 1.37. After decimal, there will be 2 digits. Because in the denominator, it is 100. Number of zeros in 100 are 2. True? So, it will be written 1.37. Then, 1450A divided by 1000. Then, if 1458 is divided by 1000, how many zeros are there? There are 3 zeros, and in the denominator there are 4 digits. Then how many digits to our right will be shifted after the decimal? 3. How many? 3, because there are 3 zeros in denominator. It will become 1.458. 1.458. Okay. Now, in practice on number 4, you are asked to write, convert the fractions into decimals. Convert the fractions into decimals. So, rule kya hai? The number of digits after the decimal point depends upon the number of zeros in the denominator. Condition ye hai ki zeros ke saath 1 hona chahiye. Okay? Jaise 10 ho gaya, denominator mein 10 ho gaya, 100 ho gaya, 1000 ho gaya, 10,000 ho gaya. That will depend on the number of zeros. Okay? Ye nahi hai ki ek zero aa gaya, 20 bhi ho sakta hai wo. To us case mein nahi hoga na. Only with 1. The zero should be with 1. Okay? The number of digits after the decimal point depends on the number of zeros in the denominator. Where there is no whole number, write 0 at the whole number position. Okay? Jab 0 nahi hota, to whole number mein hame 0 lagana zaruri hota hai. Then, let's convert the fractions into decimal. This is practice on 4. Convert the following fractions into decimals. Into decimals. Into decimal numbers. Okay. Then, fourth question is right here. 27 upon 1000. Okay. Now, number of zeros here are 1, 2, 3. And here in the denominator it is 1, 2. We will put 1, 0 from our side. It can be written as, this is actually 27. Na? Okay. 1, 2, 3 zeros were there. But in the denominator there were how many digits? 2, only 2. And we need one more. We have just completed 3 digits in the denominator here by putting 1, 0 in the left hand side. In the left hand side. You will not put here after 7. You will not put, it will become 270. Okay. If you will put, that will be wrong. So put 0 before here 27. It will remain 27. Na? Okay. Now there are 3 zeros and these 3 digits will be shifted after decimal and you will put 1 0 in the whole number 0. These all 3 digits will be shifted after decimal. So the number of digits after the decimal point depends on the number of zeros in the denominator with 1. 1 ke saath honi chahiye, okay? Now, this will be written like this. You will convert the fractions into decimal in this way. Okay? Now, let's come one more topic here. Converting decimal numbers into fractions. Here, what do? We rewrite the number. Till then, you can note down. Converting decimal numbers to fractions, okay? Rewrite the number without decimal as numerator and write the denominator with 1 followed by as many zeros as the digits after the decimal place. After the decimal place. So, let's take one of the question from here of practice zone 5. Convert the following decimal numbers into fractions. Next question. Convert decimal into fraction. Convert, this is practice zone 5. Convert decimal numbers to fraction. Decimal number to fraction. To fraction. Here the question is 3.95 I am taking like that. Okay. Here one of the topic is also being converted. Decimal into fraction. Then how can we write? What will you do here? You will write the number without decimal. Decimal ke bina, decimal ko hata diye, okay? Remove decimal. It will be written like that 395. When there was decimal, this was 3.95. For writing decimal number to fraction, you will remove the decimal and write the number without decimal. Write the number without decimal as numerator and write the denominator with 1. Jo denominator hai, decimal ka kya ho jata hai? 1. Decimal ka kya ho jata hai? 1. Okay, in place of decimal, you will write 1. Decimal ki jagah kya lagate hai? Decimal point ki jagah 1. Or after 2 digits are there, you will put 2 zeros. You will put 2 zeros. And this further can be simplified in the lowest term. In the lowest term. Okay. Then again I can take one of the question here also of your practice zone 3. 16. Question is here. Comparison was done. It is 34.1. Okay. The steps are like that. You will remove decimal for writing numerator. For writing numerator. This was 34.1. Okay? 34.1. Earlier this part was B part. and this is now 34.65. I'm sorry. Now remove decimal and write the numerator. Please begin. 341. Now in place of decimal, this point, decimal number, this is decimal point, you write 1. And number of digits, after that, only 1, put 1 0. In this way, the decimal numbers will be written in the fraction form. In the fraction form. Okay? You will complete practice zone 3, 4 and 5. Very simple. Thank you.